We're going to do the baseline for Swing from Oil on Canvas or from Gentlemen Take Polaroids, depending. They're both the same, really. So I'm just going to play it here and hopefully play along, and then I'll show you what I'm doing. I hope you can see these lines, can you? Yeah, not too bad. I'll be explaining as we go along anyway. Right, here we go. So it's basically the same thing several times, and only the root note changes. So the first time it's a B, bum, 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 bum. Then F sharp, same riff, and then it goes back to B. And then the E, and the same riff again. So you got your basic root note changes. The riff is the same, and then you move on to the now your feet, which is the pre-chorus, isn't it? Right, so I'll show you this bit first. So we're going to start on a B, which is the second fret on your A string, which is the second string. Okay, you can see my hand now. So you play a B there, and with your any other finger, like you use your left finger if you like, you're going to play the 4th fret on the D string and slide down. Right. I've watched a lot of video of him doing it, and he seems to keep his hand still, so I assume he's doing it with his little finger. I don't. Everything else I'll try to keep as he plays it, okay? So you go B on the 2nd fret to F sharp on the 4th fret on the D string and slide down to hit the B again. So the first bit is okay. The next part is we go to the F sharp with our index finger, and we're going to play the So that's the D string 4th fret. You're going to go to the D string 7th fret and slide to the 5th fret. So it's use whatever fingers you like there. The important part is that when you get to this part, this you slide up this neck as high as you can go and as quickly. So he goes. Fret on the D string, slide down, hit the B again, onto the 4th fret D string, to the 7th fret D string, again make that a pull off. The important part is you're going from the 4th fret to the 7th fret to the 5th fret. And now a big swipe up the whole neck. The next part, so you've got that bit. Dun, 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 dun. Now your next part is you go to the A string on the 9th fret to the 7th fret, a pull off. So you can play that with your 3rd finger, the 9th fret on the A string with your 3rd finger, or with your 4th finger, makes no difference. But we're going to have our index finger on the 7th fret ready to go. So on the A string. So 9th fret to the 7th. Now I've seen guys on YouTube, play the D after this. So like this. I can't find any footage of them doing that. You can if you know where there's some, you might let me know. But what I hear is just this, the ninth to the seventh. Okay. And we're going to hit the F sharp on the first, on the heaviest string, your E string, on the second fret. And a big slide up to the fifth fret. To the third fret on the same string. So it goes. Okay, so F sharp, so the second fret, fifth fret, third fret. But see this, when you hit this E, this fifth fret here, which is an A, he does it really wide. It's a really wide smear. Right? Which actually made it very hard to hear. I had to slow it right down to hear that it was an A and not say that, an F sharp or whatever. So I'll just give you that bit again. So you'd be amazed how far along we are, right? Okay, so that's one whole section. Now the next section is exactly the same, except that instead of starting on a B, we're going to start on an F sharp, right? Which is the second fret on your E string. And we're going to do the same riff, so up to the fourth fret on the D string. Back to the F sharp on the E. And this thing again. Back to the B. And lastly, we're going to hit that's the third section, so it goes B, F sharp, B. And this one's E, your open E string, and the same riff again. That's your whole verse, intro. And verse. So have you got it? So it's bum, 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 bum. F sharp. Back to B. E. Okay, your next bit I'll do in a separate video. It's windy. Do you hear that wind? Okay, so the next part is your pre-chorus. We're going to start on a B, so I'll play along with it over here, and then I'll stop and I'll show you how to play it. You ready? Don't know why I'm saying, are you ready? You can't answer me. Answer in the comments below, are you ready? Here we go. We're going to start in a B. So now your feet over, now your feet. So you could even time it using those three words. So the first note was a B, which is the second fret in your A string. Your next note was an open E string. And then your third note is the second fret on the E string. Now your feet, now your feet. Your next note, he slides from the second fret or the third fret, it doesn't really matter, up to the fourth fret on the D string. You get that lovely. So start again. Two notes there. A little gap. You can hear the timing of it yourself if you listen. Your next note then is the fifth fret on the A string to the fourth fret. So we'll go over that again. He does that again. So now your feet are back on the ground. Okay. Again, she'll, and that's a, this next section is B. Now, again, you could play this part up the neck, but I've slowed it down so many times and watched as much video as I can. You can catch glimpses of them playing little bits of it, but I think this is right. The notes are correct, but I think this is how he's getting to where he's getting, because you can actually hear those slides, right? So it's B, C. So B, which is the second fret in your A string, to the fourth fret in your D strings. Okay, now the next is a long slide. So boom, boom, up to the seventh on the D string. Okay. Now slide again up to the ninth. Okay, so it's all a slide. Now, with our index finger, the next two notes come pretty close together, so we're going to play them both. And basically, what you're doing is on the seventh fret, you're going to bridge across the A and the D string. So, ba ba bum, ba ba dum, bum, 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 bum. To the ninth fret on the A string, to the seventh fret on the D string, to the ninth fret on the D string. Now, this is the sneaky bit. He's gonna slide slightly, so he's gonna pull back slightly to the seventh fret on the D on the D string and slide back up to where he was, to the ninth fret on the D string. And your index finger on the G string on the seventh fret and back to the ninth fret on the D string. Now, I know that sounds confusing, so I'm going to say it again. So, but they're pretty close. Okay, so one more time. Here's your slide. He uses that quite a lot. That little thing is in loads of his. And now we're ready for the chorus. Now the chorus. I always find this harder to explain than to do. So wish me luck. I'll play along with this, all right?
Relax and swing.
Okay, so you might have noticed we switched to the Gentlemen Take Polaroids version because it's easier to explain on that one. Okay, so we're going to go again on the B. So, second fret in your A string, to the F sharp, which is the fourth fret on your D string. So, I'm just trying to figure out which finger would be easiest. Yeah, I'd use my little finger for that. So B, F sharp. Okay, or I could use my third. Yeah, use your third. Okay, so boom, ba-da. Okay, so that bit is your F sharp on your D to the second fret on your G string and back. And the note after that is the fourth fret on the G string. So ba 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 bum. So it's first half of the chorus goes there. The second half it changes a little bit. Okay, so it's just for that bit again. B, F sharp. There's a little bit of a connective tissue, if you like, a little riff that connects both things. And what that is a B, again on your A string, so second fret in your A string, fourth fret in your A string, your D string open, to the second fret on your D string, and your A string open. So, bum, 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 bum. Okay, the rhythm of it you'll hear as you listen to the record. Yeah. So, bum, 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 bum. Okay, then the second part of that chorus, it goes to the B, and then the D string open, to the G string open, and we're going to do, so it's like, and. So, yeah, this is what I'm saying, it's quite confusing, so there's your first part. So you do that twice, B, D open, G open, so G open to the A on your G string, so second fret in your G string open, fourth fret in your G string, so it's, so it's essentially a G chord. And actually, I know on canvas he doesn't hit the B, he hits the G. But on this version, he's hitting the B again. So, okay. So those two bits, and then to finish off, you hit the G, which is the third fret on your E string, and this little riff to bring you back in to the drums. So it's F sharp on your D string to, which is the fourth fret on your D string, to the fifth fret on your D string, the seventh fret on your D string, to the fourth fret on your D string, and then you're back into the riffs, things you say, right? So just to run over it again. Did I miss the B? Oh yeah. So after the G, you hit a B. Which is the, again, still the second fret in your A string. Okay, and the only thing that changes is over the Whisper in the Wind part, he does the riff, but all on the B. It doesn't change around the chords. It stays on the B. And the last, the outro and swing with all the lovely keyboard parts coming in. It sounds like the chorus, but it's not quite, right? What he's doing over that bit is... So this is your whole outro. Your whole fade out is... So what that is again, your B on your A string to the fourth fret on your D string, and your little bouncy part from the chorus, open G, A, open G, B on the G string to fourth fret, B to the D flat, so B to the fourth fret, open D, A on the second fret of the D string, and this is what's different, is you hit this note again, this fourth fret on the A string on the way down, so and swing and swing. Anyway, I hope my bumbling explanation was of use to you. Like I say, I watch a lot of video and I've slowed a lot of the audio down. I take the center out of the audio so that all the bits hard left and right aren't in the way. Take everything off above 500 hertz and slow it down so you can really just hear these bass tracks a lot better. So if you know, if you try doing that yourself, right, and you're working out, and look, thanks for indulging me. thanks for watching. Take care. Keep Karn and fret less, as Tim Mick Karn say. Take care.